this video, we will discuss a TI design audio preprocessing demo for the C5517. The demo consists of a C5517 EVM connected to a linear microphone board or LMB that has four microphones in a linear geometry. The microphone array board is connected to the C5517 EVM with two I2S lines. There are a few algorithms that run on the C5517 that does the audio processing. There's a beamformer, an adaptive spectral noise reduction algorithm, a multi-source selection algorithm, and a dynamic range control algorithm. The output of the process audio is sent via a headphone jack to the user. The process audio is then output via headphone so that the user can evaluate the quality of the audio processing. Alternatively, the audio can also be piped to a PC so that the audio can be recorded and analyzed in some kind of software such as Audacity or Adobe Audition. Code Composer Studio running on the PC will be used to control the C5517 in order to load the binary and do other debugging. The demo can be tested by standing in front of the microphone array and speaking to it while simultaneously having some sort of a noise source coming from a different angle. The test environment can be manipulated as needed to see the performance of the audio preprocessing. In order to run the demo, there are a few hardware pieces that are required. A PC with Code Composer Studio, a C5517 EVM, a linear microphone board, some jumper wires, a pair of headphones, a USB cable, and a power supply for the C5517 EVM. There are some jumper setting changes that are needed on the C5517 EVM in order to run this demo properly. The TI design guide also has details on the different connection settings. Next, you will need some jumper wires to connect the linear microphone board to the C5517 EVM. Please follow along here as tags are shown throughout this video to indicate the different connections that are needed. Now we will connect the jumper wires that were connected to the C5517 EVM to the linear microphone board. A list of connections are shown here on the far right. Please take care to not cross any wires. Connect the headphones to the P9 connector, which is a green colored connector on the C5517 EVM. Connect a USB cable to the emulator on the EVM. Once all the connections are complete, please double check to ensure that nothing has been crossed. Go ahead and power on the board, and a red LED on the EVM should light up indicating power. A green LED on the linear microphone board should also illuminate, indicating that the LMB is powered as well. Let's now switch gears to the software side of things and getting set up with Code Composer Studio. There are a few files that you would need in order to patch the source code before building the source code files. Navigate to the TI design guide and scroll down to the related documentation section to open the C55X voice processing wiki. Once the page is open, scroll down to the software design section and download the patch.zip files. The video assumes that the C55X CSL package has already been installed in the system. Links to download this package are provided in the TI design guide and also in the For More Information section at the end of this video. Navigate to the audio preprocessing folder and replace the files as shown here. The three files that need to be replaced are sysbfflt.c, codec_pcm186x.c and audiocodec_dma.c. The reason behind patching these files is that the original source code was built for a different microphone array that had 8 microphones in total. This issue will be addressed in a subsequent CSL release that will have the patches already incorporated. There are some dependencies that will also have to be satisfied in order to build this demo. Links to these dependent packages are provided in the TI design guide. AER, VoiceLib, DSP BIOS, XDS, and XDC tools are some of the components that are needed to run this demo. Please ensure that the software directory structure is configured as shown here. Let's import the bf_rt_bios project into the CCS workspace. Project is stored at demos, audio preprocessing, /C5517. There are a couple of other dependent packages that are needed in order to build this demo. There's ATAFS BIOS DRV lib and C55XXCSL_LP. Both of these projects are located in the examples folder in the C55XCSL package. Prior to building the demo, ensure that the correct C5517 macro is defined in CSL_general.h. The line that needs to be paid attention to is indicated here by the yellow arrow. Next, we will build the BFRT BIOS project. Once the build is completed, the .out file will be in the debug folder, as shown over here. Let's now run the demo. Launch the C5517 target configuration, connect the core, and then load the .out file. Hit the resume button in Code Composer Studio to run the executable. At this point, there will be some printouts on the console showing that the demo is running. A little blue LED on the underside of the LMB will also illuminate to show that the codecs have been initialized properly. At this point, the demo is running, and the audio that's captured through the microphone array would be heard through the headphones that are connected to the C5517 EVM. The left headphone ear would have the processed audio, and the right headphone ear would have the unprocessed audio. This provides a mechanism for the user to be able to evaluate the quality of the audio processing in the demo. You can rub your finger over each microphone to hear which mic can be heard over which earphone. Please be careful as you rub your fingers on the microphones, as the volume levels can be very high. Optionally, an external USB sound card can also be connected to the headphone jack in order to pipe the audio to a PC. This will provide a mechanism to analyze the audio in some kind of a software such as Audacity or Adobe Audition. To do this, you would connect the line in to the external USB sound card and the other end of the line in cable to the headphone jack on the C5517 EVM. Connect the USB sound card via a USB cable to the PC. In this example, we are using Audacity to analyze the audio. Ensure that the correct sound source is selected in Audacity. In order to test this demo, go ahead and start the recording on Audacity and simultaneously play some white noise in the background and speak into the microphone array.
Testing 1-2, testing 1-2.
Zoom into the waveforms in order to see the noise suppression levels. The audio track can also be split into left and right channels in order to analyze each side separately. For more information on the resources discussed in this video, please see the links here.
For questions about this demonstration, please post to the Texas Instruments E2E community in the C5000 Ultra Low Power DSP forum.
This concludes this demonstration video. Thank you for watching.